It's good to see you all this morning. I've been reading a book, and Sabina shared a little bit from Brian McLaren's framework around like faith after doubt. And I'm reading another one of his books, and it's called We Make the Road by Walking. And I wanted to read to you something from that book. And it says, if you ask what language the Creator speaks, the best answer is this: God's first language is full spectrum, light, clear water, deep sky, red squirrel, blue whale, grey parrot, green lizard, rainbow lorikeet, orange mango, laughing child, rolling river, green forest, churning storm, and spinning planet. A psalmist said the same thing in another way. The universe is God's work of art, God's handiwork. All created things speak or sing of the God who made them. I don't know if you remember, quite a few years ago now, the whale song. Remember hearing about that? And they recorded, you know, the whales in their, I don't have the right language for whatever it is, but they recorded the whale song. And it was just, the sound, through the sound waves, it was just incredible, the whale song. It was spectacular. So if we want to know what the Creator was like, is like, a good place to start would be to enjoy the art of creation. Enjoy the art of creation. And the activation, like this book, the book that I'm reading has a little activation after each chapter of how you can, you've read it and now how you can start to put it into your life. And the activation from this chapter and the book was to choose one facet of creation that you love. And you observe it, you think about it, you learn about it every chance you can. And with this question in mind, if that element of creation were your only Bible, what would it tell you about God? So I thought that was a great challenge. And for me, it was quite easy because there's certain things I really love about creation. So I'm going to start with some scripture, and you might be able to guess, I get what I'm going to share about. But thank you, Lord. Let's just take a moment just before I read the scriptures, and let's just pause for a moment and just thank you, Lord. Thank you for your presence. Thank you for the gift of life. Thank you for the incredible gift of creation and how it speaks and reveals to us of your nature. And this morning, I'm thankful for these people in this place that we gathered as family. And we thank you for this opportunity as we come around and we share. My prayer this morning is that we would remember, that we would be reminded of your great love for us, Father. And so I thank you in Jesus' name. So Ian's going to bring up some scriptures and you can read along with me. The first one is Psalms 19, verses 1 to 6. And it says, the heavens declare the glory of God. The skies proclaim the work of his hands. Day after day, they pour forth speech. Night after night, they reveal knowledge. They have no speech. They use no words. No sound is heard from them, yet their voice goes out into all the earth, their words to the ends of the world. In the heavens, God has pitched a tent for the sun. It is like a bridegroom coming out of his chamber, like a champion rejoicing to run his course. It rises at one end of the heavens and makes its circuit to the other. Nothing is deprived of its warmth. What a beautiful scripture. Luke 1, verse 78 and 79, this is from the Message translation. It says, Through the earth-felt mercies of our God, God's sunrise will break in upon us, shining on those in darkness, those sitting in the shadow of death, then showing us the way, one foot at a time, down the path of peace. Beautiful. Lamentations 3:22-24 says, because of the Lord's great love, we are not consumed, for his compassion never fail. They are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness. Say to myself, the Lord is my portion. Therefore, I will wait for him. Psalm 143:8 says, let the morning bring me word of your unfailing love, for I have put my trust in you. Show me the way I should go, for to you I entrust my life. Psalm 90:14 says, satisfy us in the morning with your unfailing love, that we may sing for joy and be glad in all our days. Psalm 65:8 says, O God, to the furthest corners of the planet, people will stand in awe, startled and stunned by your signs and wonders. Sunrise brilliance and sunset beauty both take turns singing their songs of joy to you. Psalm 108:2 says, arise, my soul, and sing his praises. I will awaken the dawn with my worship, greeting the daybreak with my songs of light. So you might by now have some idea about what aspect of creation that I was going to be learning from and observing. And if sunrise was the only Bible, what would the sunrise reveal to me about God? Well, that was easy for me. I am an avid sunriser, and an avid sunrise photographer. I love experiencing sunrise, and I thought I'd show you some of the ones that I've experienced, and hopefully just wish there was music. I'm going to just sit down here for a sec. This goes for 3 minutes. Uluru, as you'll see. Ah, that's my favorite. You might know that person. Maggie. Lena was there too. The mud looks good.
Which way the wind blows when this day is done. Breathe set your intentions, dream with care. Tomorrow's a new day for everyone. A brand new moon and brand new sun.
I think that's it. I've got so many more, but I couldn't load them all onto a video. But yeah. So if Sunrise was the only Bible, here's some of the things that it reveals to me. The first thing that Sunrise reveals to me about God and His ways is that awareness leads to participation. Sharon was talking about that. If I want to experience the sunrise, I have to be awake and I have to be present to it. And God is breathing invitation in each morning. And every new morning can be an altar, an encounter with the divine, an invitation to participate in God's good work. Sunrise gifts me with a fresh opportunity to make a positive impact, to be the change that I wish to see in the world, and to be kind and to be compassionate. Sunrise reminds me that every day is the opportunity for a new beginning. That today is not a repeat of yesterday. Every day the sun will rise. And sunrise reveals to me that Christ is ever-present. He's an ever-present reality, unfolding in the ordinary aspects of our lives again and again and again. You know, the sun rises differently according to the times and seasons. It's in different positions. In the winter, the sun rises much later, and in the summer, much earlier. In the southern hemisphere, which is where we are, the great southern land, in the winter, the sun rises in the northeast, and in summer, the southeast. And so just as in life we experience different seasons, like we're all in a different season, We experience different times, seasons and times, beginnings and endings, open doors and closed ones, and that we are invited to live with holy awareness and discernment. Holy awareness and discernment, open-hearted, with eyes and ears to hear and see and discern our season. Like, what season are you in? What season am I in? What are the open doors? What are the ones that are closed? Sunrise reminds us that we are people who are led by the Spirit and that we have discernment. And the Creator of each new sunrise invites me to make time to reflect and be thankful, like, for what is ending. Like, sometimes we think endings are, you know, endings can be hard, but we can be really thankful because with an ending, we know that there's been so much that has happened along that way. And we can be grateful for what was learned and what was accomplished. Like if I take time to reflect and be thankful and grateful for what has been. And sunrise gives me the opportunity to celebrate these new beginnings and the things that we have to look forward to. Like, especially as we get a bit older, it's easier to reflect on, where did all the years go, you know? But it's also the opportunity to reflect on what's ahead of us. We've still got great things ahead of us. And to be grateful for those that we have and for those around with us whom we share these changes. Sunrise reveals to me to remain optimistic and hopeful for what is yet to come. And the new relationships and the new beginnings, what they might bring. Sunrise reveals that God is with us through all the events of our lives. God is with us. And that these endings and that these new beginnings are no different. God is with us. Just before sunrise, I love this. Just before sunrise, there's this thing they call first light. And first light, it just has a different feel about it. You'll know what I mean if you experience it and if you're aware of it. It just has a different feel. There's a sense of this expectation. There really is. And the birds begin to sing. At first light, the birds begin to sing. And they begin to sing their new songs. You know, I remember, like, I don't know, maybe it was a year ago, used to get up, you know, a particular time each morning, and I used to sit in a certain place, you know, when I was at home, and I couldn't actually see, you know, the sunrise. But when first dawn was coming, like, there were these birds. There was one particular bird, and every morning at the same time, it sang its song. I recorded it because after a few days, I started to notice it, and I was like, this is happening every morning. And I did record it, but I'm not going to play it for you. But it was like amazing, just first light and just the feel that it has. There's this sense of expectation. The birds begin to sing, and you get a sense that this is holy ground, that we're standing on holy ground. And I get to come aside at sunrise and be still and know that He is God. And a sense of expectation can rise in my heart like a new song. And the thing about sunrise, as you saw from those photos and from your own experiences of it, sunrise is bathed in color. Like, it's incredible, the colors. But there's one dominant color. It's like gold. Everything gets bathed in gold, this golden glory. And even the Cairns Esplanade, the mud flats, look amazing bathed in gold. Even the worst of my circumstances, all those things that are around me that look really, really hard and really unpleasant, can we see them bathed in glory? Can we see them with new eyes? And each morning, I'm invited to catch a glimpse of glory. I can actually see glory. I can see with a sense of what glory might look like, and that this glory fills the whole earth. Amen. When you see the sun start to come up, it's like a blaze. It's like a little, if you're looking out over the horizon and you can see it rising, it's like a little slither of gold. It's just incredible. And when the sun begins to invade the first light, it gradually illuminates the world and colours change and things begin to look different. Our circumstances begin to look different. It's reminding me that God was in Christ reconciling the world to Himself, and that we too, as Henry was sharing, are invited into this ministry of reconciliation. It's like, you know, it's like we get to be and show the love of God, to touch people with His love. But you know what? Sometimes in order to see, we need to look through a different lens. Because, like, if we've got a lens, we've got a filter, if I'm wearing dark glasses, like, I'm not going to see it. I need to change my perspective. I need to change the lens. If I'm looking through a lens of unforgiveness or bitterness or whatever, I need to change my lens in order to see, change our perspective. From a physiological perspective, research shows that there's a direct link between sunlight and serotonin. And serotonin is the body's feel-good chemical. And when sunlight stimulates the retinas in your eyes, it triggers your brain to produce serotonin. I'm reminded that this is the day that the Lord has made, and I will rejoice in it. And be glad. Rejoice and be glad in it. Sunrise can help trigger that, those feelings of good well-being. Research has revealed that sunrise and sunset, I love them too, may also trigger significant boosts in people's feelings of awe. And research, it's very hard to measure awe, but research indicates that awe has the potential to improve mood, enhance positive social behaviour and increase positive emotions. I remember when Corinne and I went to, what was that place in New Zealand? Can you remember what it was called? Tianu? Talk about awe and wonder everywhere. I don't think there should be any unhappy people living down there because it's spectacular and everywhere you look, it's awe and wonder. And, you know, sunrise each day reveals in us this sense of awe and wonder. Sometimes it's breathtaking. Like sometimes it's being catching some of those sunrises is actually breathtaking. And all you can say is, wow. All you can say is, wow. And it's reminding us of a God who is still working miracles. That he's a God of wow and awe and wonder. It reveals that we can learn to live in the grace of the day, of this new day. This day has a grace in it, has a grace available for me to lean into this day. That we can cease striving. Man, that can be a struggle. That we can be still and we can know that God is able. And in the language of recovery, it's to surrender our lives and will to the care of God. Surrender means opening our hands to let go of striving. Remember a few weeks ago, I talked about those three postures that hands up in prayer, surrender. Hands out is receiving. And hands pointed this way is about mission. Surrender means opening our hands to let go of striving, to receive and experience the love of God that he has for us. You know, I've talked a lot this year about learning to live, love, and lead well. But God invites us to learn his unforced rhythms of grace, to create a rhythm in our lives that looks like getting away with him. Sunrise is an opportunity to get away with God, even for just an hour, half an hour, to create a rhythm in our lives that looks like getting away with him. Our true source, and learning to live, love, and lead from a place of rest, no striving. And he promises us recovery. Recovery. Are you burnt out on religion? Come away with me. Learn. I'll teach you the unforced rhythms of grace and you'll recover your life. Amen? Amen. Recovery. You know, and sunrise teaches me that it's okay to go slow with myself. That love takes time to make all things new. And that's his life. It's his life that's the light that defines my life, his light. Sunrise reveals that today isn't a do-over of yesterday, but it's a brand new day. So if I could have those that are handing out communion, please, this morning. I'm just going to get Ian to just play that slideshow again. And I want to invite you this week. I want to invite you, maybe it's sunrise. Maybe you can make some decisions that this week that you're going to get up early. Pick a day that it's not going to rain. The sun still rises on rainy days, but you just can't necessarily see it with our naked eye. But this week, I want to invite you to choose one facet of creation that you love. It could be the birds, the trees, the weather, the soil, water, light, children, sleep. Pick something.
maybe, if you think that's creation. I mean, I guess the men are, women, men and women are created, if you want to choose rugby.
But choose something this week and allow, if that was the only Bible that you had, what would it reveal to you about God? So that's my challenge for you this week. One aspect of creation. If that was your only Bible, what would it teach you? What would it reveal to you about God? And I want you to, hopefully you can reflect and see God in that aspect that you've chosen. So once you've got your communion, Ian's just going to show that slide.
And I just want you to allow a silent prayer of gratitude to rise within you. And when you're ready, just take of communion. And we could have that song again. That was good.
Direction of the birds, direction of love. Breathe, breathe in the air. Cherish this moment, cherish this breath. Tomorrow's a new day for everyone. Brand new moon, brand new sun. When you feel life coming down on you like a heavy weight. When you feel this crazy society adding to the strain. Take a stroll to the nearest water's edge. Remember your place. Many moons have risen and fallen long before you came. So which way is the wind blowing? And what does your heart say? Which way the wind blows when this day is done.
If anyone wants to finance my dream job, it would be traveling the world taking photos of sunrise. So if you have those resources and you want to share, let me know. Amen. Why don't we stand? I'm going to pray. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Father, I thank you this morning for creation. We don't worship creation, but it reminds us of the Creator. And we're so thankful. We're so thankful that you speak to us in, you know, ways that we all can understand. And so I pray for these people this morning. I pray for just times of refreshing of through the Holy Spirit. I pray times of refreshing to all of us. I pray that we'd be refreshed in our faith, that we'd be refreshed in our hearts, refreshed in our vision, refreshed in our love for God, refreshed in our desire for His presence, and to be aware of His presence, refreshed with fresh ears and fresh eyes and an open heart. I pray for those who are experiencing challenges and disappointments. I pray for them that they would be find refreshment, Lord God, and that Your love would be revealed to them afresh, Lord God. I pray that that hope would rise in their hearts. That Lord, that You would remind them of Your constant love for them, Lord. That You're always present, that You never leave, and that You never forsake. And through all of the different seasons in our lives, I pray that we would be reminded of Your great love for us. And so I bless these people, Lord. I bless them in Your name, Jesus. Amen. Amen. Amen.